Hey everybody, it's Momentary Flux. Welcome back to Factorio, where we are continuing to work on our minimalist factory here. There's a few things left to do before we end the series, and we got a little bit into it last episode where we went up and we field tested a few of the weapons. But what I need to do here is I need to finish up getting all of these destroyer bots and laser bots and all that stuff. I need to finish it up. I was kind of halfway through it when we encountered an alien attack. They got a little pissed off at my pollution cloud that they moved into. Not my fault. What can you do? It looks like this is just holding the wrong thing. So I think we left off here where we were just working our way from left to right through these assemblers. Getting everything to work. I had blueprinted the setup from the logistics bots to make it work, and I think it just there's a few different requirements. So it looks like we need to get the robot weapons here. So we're just missing the blue batteries, the silver zinc batteries. So, let's see, what do we need? So the titanium and the batteries. Not the bearings, though. Okay. So we can get rid of this stuff. There we go. Okay, so those are being made. And the brains. Oh, ice. Yeah. So the three electronic components. All right, let's just dump those in here. They'll get used up. So that's, I forgot that there was an insert going that way as well. Actually, these guys are getting, yeah, these guys, I screwed that one up too. So the circuit boards and then transistors. Do I have any of those circuit boards? Nope. Transistors and components. There we go. All right. Looks good there. So these are missing the brains, and that's because, oh yeah, the green boards. All right, there they go. So now we're getting destroyer bots. And then after the destroyer bots, we need Mark IV robot frames. So this is holding a blue card, which is the wrong one. Okay. So I see up here that they were feeding the brains for the next set above, but they're not doing that here. So we could cancel that. Let's actually just, oop, what technology finished? This is the shooting speed. Okay, that's the last one. Let's just copy this here. Yeah. And I can take these into my inventory. Don't need them. Okay, so there's the frames are going, and then now the frames are filling up, so we just need the tools. And the tools need this stuff, the nitinol, silver zinc, polished diamonds. so this needs the blank blue cards, all of the circuit stuff. So we have all the circuit stuff. Blank blue cards, and then silicon nitride, is that, yep, and then nitinol, batteries, and diamonds. Was it the bearings? Sorry, the gears. and then diamonds, polished diamonds for those lasers. Okay, sweet. And that should be everything. Nice. So we have laser robots. Okay, I'm going to let those build up. I'm not going to take any of those right now. I'm going to save that for my weapons testing. So I'll let those build up. We'll have a little stack of each flavor. We'll try those out after the series is over, after we get our launch. Okay, so that's all the robots. I actually have more. I have more artifacts now, which is great. I probably should have kept some of those before they're going to be carried off to make stuff. Yeah, I do want to make a better fusion reactor. So I need some orange and some blue. Let's see if I can request those. I'll try to request 20. Let's see if they got used up already. I'm just going to keep those in there until I get those, because I actually want double that. I want 30 because I need to make two reactors. So 15 times 2, that makes more sense. Okay. So how's everything looking here? We're looking pretty good. How's power doing? Power's full. Everything's full. Everything's looking great. Get some grenades and landmines and... Oh, I forgot to... I forgot to limit those. Oh, well. I guess I could limit these. Okay. So I think that's... pretty much all the stuff, I think. I keep looking through here, and every time I look through here, I find something new that I need to build. But I think I'm getting down to it at this point. All right, let's work on tank artillery damage. Gonna have to make some sweet tanks with some shields and stuff. So are we not making the regular rocket warheads? Yeah, we should be. Okay, I think that I'm not making the regular warheads. So these are all the... Yeah, okay. So this looks like it's for making rockets. And what I should be doing here is I should be making warheads here, not rockets. If I can find the damn things. There we are. Okay, that'll get our production going for these rockets. Excellent. I'm just looking over stuff here to see what's not being made and why it might not be being made. So that's just missing the blue projectiles. Just missing the blue alloy. Yeah, I think we need more artifacts. Yeah. All right. let me clear out my inventory, and then what I'm going to do is I'm going to head out, and I need to check my outposts. It's been a long time since I've checked them. I need to make sure that all the mining drills are still working, that kind of stuff. So let's get out there and do that. As soon as I make some room. What else can I toss here? Yeah, okay. I think that's good. Still have these robotic attack drones. They kind of suck, though. All right, so real quick check-in. That one's finished, obviously. This one's almost finished. 82, 36. These were the final ones that I put. And these ones are just short on rocket fuel. Let me do a real quick check on rocket fuel, and then I'm going to see. I've got, how much ammo do I have? I've got a good amount of ammo. I suppose I could top up on laser batteries. Get some over here. Keep 100 of those. Each one of these laser batteries actually has 50 shots. So that's quite a lot of shots. What was I doing? I was looking at the solid fuel. Oops, that's not what I want to do. That's what I want to do. We want more solid fuel, as much as possible. That's what those, all the rockets are waiting to launch. They need the solid fuel. Okay, let's hop aboard the train. I'm trying to think, maybe I'll just take a couple of these laser bots with me. Let's take 100 of these guys. And clear some space here. Techs are coming fast and furious. All right, let's get up there and let's go take a look. Let's just make the tour around the base. I need to do this. I haven't done this in a long time. So let's see here. Where can we start? Let's check the map. I want to go. Let's start down at Copper 2, and then we'll just work our way around clockwise from Copper 2. Yeah, I don't think I've been out to Copper 2 since I built it. So let's get out there. Kick back and enjoy the ride. I do want to see if there's any aliens around. I should probably put a radar at Copper 2. I don't see any radar coverage. There could be a nest right there, who knows? Yeah, I can see the Iron 1 needs some love. It's a lot of empty drills up there. And since I'm out and about, I might as well put in my exoskeletons. Okay, well that looks good. Otherwise, I guess we're not using very much copper. Okay, so Iron 1. Oh, before I almost forgot. Radar. I don't see any turrets here either. I'm going to put it. So I have some laser turrets that I put them back in, didn't I? I should have some turrets of some nature. Yeah. Well, that should deter our little friends. Okay, good. There's nobody in range of the radar. So we're okay there. Let's head up to Iron 1. And I know I did see as we flew by there that there was a bunch of mining drills that need to be removed. Yeah. See, I do have a radar here, and I see that there's. I think I'm gonna run out here and push those guys back a little bit while I'm here, because otherwise they're gonna end up attacking soon. With this diamond pickaxe, it's almost faster just to do this myself rather than to task the construction bots to do it. Alright, cool. This only takes a second since I have my big my exoskeletons. I'm gonna try some of these laser bots. See how they fare. Ah, there it is. Or no, there's one up here in the tree. Oh, Jesus. Well, they're not being deployed. I guess I not have the tech to deploy them? Yeah, I'm gonna have to look at that. I guess I need this technology in order to even have any of them out there, huh? Well, time to find out, because I have it now. See one worm out there in the water. Not anymore. All right, so I'm clicking all over the place here, and I can't seem to deploy these. Do these go in my suit? Or do they go in my regular inventory? Or I'm really confused by this. I mean, I've got a RoboPort. Yeah, I don't know. There might be another technology that I'm missing, perhaps. It seems odd that... seems like that shouldn't really be the case, but I'm not sure. I assume that they would be like defender capsules and whatnot that you just sort of spam onto the map and they would deploy, but that's not happening. Well, I guess I'll just keep going down this line here. Holy moly. Maybe I just need... Well, I'll do a few more of these and just to see... Seems to work pretty good using the rifle to destroy the nests and the worms. They seem to be a little bit softer, unarmored, and then using the laser on the armored beasties that are chasing me. All right, let's try this one more time here. We'll see. Okay, so you got these robotic attack drones, right? So I put those on the map. and they start shooting. Yeah, I'm really not understanding because, I mean, these guys, you can see they got deployed, right? And it would be nice if the my construction bots could pick those up, but they can't. Those things are so cool. I wish they were better. We'll just keep researching and then, you know, see, I tried to do that with these. Nothing. Click them on myself. Yeah, I'm unsure of how this that's supposed to work. I mean, it's kind of weird because, you know, the construction bots and the logistics bots, you need them in your inventory for them to work. I'm just wondering if there's something sort of like an equivalent to a personal roboport that would allow for combat robots, and that maybe that they're not destroyed, you know what I'm saying? That they would be sort of semi-permanent until they were killed. But I mean, I've got the technologies. Yeah, I guess I'll just have to look into that sort of offline and see what the deal is. I mean, they require a lot of resources to make, so I would like to find out, and I would like to be able to test them. All right, so how far are we over here? Let's get a couple more nests, and we'll head on back, or we'll continue our tour. Getting down to the nitty-gritty on the tank research, which is pretty cool. I find it such a hassle to use the vehicles in this game that I just don't really bother. I mean, look at how fast I can run. Why do I need a tank, right? Shit. Oh my god, that was close. I got gridlocked in there. I couldn't move. Wow. That was seriously, I thought I was gonna die. And that's why I need better fusion reactors. Wow, that was insane. I totally could not get out of there. There was nothing I could do. I was just trying to kill them faster than they could crowd me. All right, so how many... Oop, wrong button. I need 30 of the orange. I need 30 of... I got 15. I'm trying to get enough to make this... Oh, it's 25. I better make these 50 then. So I don't trash them on accident. They'll come right back. Come on. That's an awful lot, actually, 50, based on the settings I have. Circle around and get at the nest here. Hard. Yeah, these biters are becoming pretty difficult to deal with. They are no pushovers, that is for sure. Okay. All right, I think that's good. No, that other nest down there to the southwest isn't really close to the pollution cloud, so I'm going to go ahead and get on back on track here and go check out the rest of the outposts. Make the rounds. Before I hop in the train, let's see here. So let's head to Lead 1 and then Silver 1. I'm probably causing a traffic jam. Yeah, it looks like it. There's still a lot of iron there. I mean, even though I'm picking up the mining drills, there's still quite a lot there. I don't have to worry about that running out or anything. Okay, that looks perfectly fine, and the zinc down there looked fine, so let's head on to Silver 1. Silver really doesn't have much use. I mean, it's for those batteries. But that's pretty much it. There's also, I think it's gun or electrum or gunmetal, but it has very limited uses. Yeah, I do think it's used in the electrum, which is used in those higher phase solar panels. But you can see, I mean, I've got one row of miners there, and it looks fine. Okay, so I think gold 1 or copper 1 is completely out. I can get that on the way back. What I want to do is let's head out to nickel 1. Actually, nickel 1 should be fine. I'm not going to worry about that. Tungsten, such a low thing. This should be good too. That's the gems. I'm curious. I'm going to go out to the gems, and I can look at titanium as I drive by. The titanium also, it seems to be pretty low on the use. There was a phase there, like sort of midway through the game, where titanium was a really, really high priority item, but it seems to have been kind of pushed back at this point. Not that, I mean, it's still being used, but just not quite to the degree it was in the mid game. Okay, so that was the stone. Stone looks okay. Titanium looks okay. Nothing to pick up. Oil cranking away. And then taking a right here down to gems. I got some oil here and it never really made use of, but I think with all, you know, the... Well, it looks like we're fine here too. See, yeah, I think those two are fine, so I guess I can head back. I think that's or actually let's go to gold 1. That's where I want to go and clean that up. But actually I'm gonna run back to the station with the train, because I can run up here faster than I can manipulate the train, so I'm just gonna take it back to base. Yeah, everything's looking good. It had been about maybe 10 or 15 hours, I think, since I last did the rounds. So it was good for me to get out here and at least know where I'm standing. I'm waiting for that last tank cannon upgrade. I think that's the last tank technology. Yeah, getting down to the last of the techs too. This is a good way to sort of it's a good reason to go out and let technology build while I'm checking on things. Okay. Let's check in. Ooh, look at this. Where's my fish? Put him in his little spot there. Nice, so three rockets are ready to go. Excellent. Yeah, and this is copper one, right? Completely toast. Construction bots from the base are coming up here to get this. There are no trains with this stop. Good. All right, that's the last of the tanks. I don't really have the alien science right now to make the Mark IV power armor. How about these? Yeah, I can make Mark III shields. That would actually be useful. Okay, I can leave those, I suppose. And let me check here. Okay, that requires more alien science. I gotta hold off on those until I get more artifacts. I can do regular alien research though. Okay, so this was, I can't remember, what was it? It was gold one. Now there's gold two is way down below, right? Yeah, okay. Let me double check to make sure that nobody's... Okay, gold two. Right, I repurposed that train. I just wanted to make sure. Okay, let's yank all this stuff here. And do we need this train stop anymore? Nope. Or this loop. Must be coming up from the base to get the rest. What the heck is this doing here? That was weird. These don't look like they connect. I pulled up a power pole on accident, or they were connecting like in a zigzag kind of way, but yeah, I disconnected the power there. Double check that. Oops. Yeah, one of the interesting aspects of playing that speed run was like I actually started using my hotkeys for the first time. I never used them. The 1, 2, 3, 4 keys and all that, just because you need to, like, in order to really... to move quickly. So I'm going to start using those in the future once I do a different game and set up my hotbars in a more logical manner. What is that guy doing? He's chasing me down. I can beat you. I can beat him. I can race him with my all my... Oops. Didn't mean to do that. Get down to 2 exoskeletons. That's about my limit in base. My speed limit, my self-imposed speed limit, running around base. Otherwise, I just overshoot everything and I can't get any sort of fine-tuned stuff. So let me try these guys here. No. Can't spam those on the ground, so it's not just the laser bots. It's this whole line of robots. I gotta figure out why I can't use those. And these grenades still haven't got any explosive fluid. And we're out of explosive fluid. I really hate to dump any of the artifacts into the logistics system, because they're going to get eaten up by these various things. And I need them to make some things like the power armor, and I might need them for shields and those kinds of things. So I'm kind of holding off. I'm gonna hold back some for personal use. Get rid of some more of this stuff though. I got a whole lot of various things here. Yeah, regular gun turrets? I wonder what I have those for. Yeah, keep researching. Anyway, I was looking through my inventory here. I have quite the assortment of stuff, don't I? Well, let's keep it going. I'm gonna grab some turrets while I'm up here. Okay. One final check here on the rockets. And we've done our rounds, so everything looked good in the base. Let's make one quick pass through here. Everything's looking pretty good. I mean, we're full up. We have tons of circuits. Tons of everything. Everything is basically maxed out and fairly idle at this point. I was looking earlier at the robot statistics. I'm just hovering over this robo chest here and taking a look on the right hand side. You can see that at any given time, about 200 robots or so are in use. So that's only 10% of the robots that we have. We have 2,700 construction robots, and I'm imagining most of those are still Mark 1s. And there's an entire chest full of robots in case we ever need to use more. But yeah, I find it interesting that, you know, after all this, the entire factory basically been moved over to the logistics network instead of belts. And only 200 robots are really in use at any given time, and sometimes even less. It looks like about 150 right now. So yeah, that's pretty cool. All right. Well, I talked about this before, but I'm kind of running out of things to build here. I've got most of the weaponry. There's a few things that I could build, like these things, you know, for the vehicles and whatever, but they're not things that I really need to make assemblers for. They're kind of one-off type stuff. Like I can build one discharge defense. I could build a couple of overdrive motors and that kind of stuff, you know, in my pocket. And so I'm not going to really make production chains for those kinds of things, because they're really things that you only need a couple of, if that. Kind of like a tank, you know, you don't need to mass produce tanks. You just need like a couple, you know. Maybe you can outfit them a little bit differently and that kind of stuff. So I'm thinking that I will continue to think about this sort of offline, but I might just let the game run and let the rockets build, let the tech finish, and then just have one final episode where, you know, I would like to talk about the factory and how I think it went, and just sort of give a recap and a summary, and then launch the rockets. And then after as sort of the prologue to this series, what I would do is I would load my character up with all of the various alien weaponry and all of, you know, outfit some tanks and just go do like, just blow up some biters, test the weapons and see how they do, get sort of like a maybe not a like a pseudo scientific test where we're not necessarily running the numbers, the spreadsheet, but more like, you know, watching how fast we can kill a base with the rifle versus how fast it goes with the flamethrower versus how fast it goes with the laser rifle, or, you know, what the, if I can ever figure out how the drones work, you know, get those going and that stuff, and see how tanks fare versus some of these Bob's enemies. And just, you know, just get a good overview there, and that'll be it. And then I'll be moving on to new series and continue on. I'm still working on Sniper Elite 4, which I hope everybody checks out. I've put a lot of time and effort into that game. I think that my gameplay is pretty good, so check it out if you want to. But anyway, I'm going to go ahead and end it here, and we'll see you next time. Thanks.